Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And so before I get started, I just want to give a big shout out to Zoe Douglas and Phil Seamark for inspiring this video, actually coming up with the solution and sharing it with me and allowing me to do a video. Dynamic format string for measures really helps out. There's lots of scenarios, but this is a unique one. I thought it was a really cool one and I decided to share it with you all. And so let's imagine you have a measure and you format it out. Enough of all this talking. You know what I like to do? Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So let's say you've created this measure, this durations in seconds. It's a pretty simple measure. And what you want to do is, instead of showing seconds, you like to break it down by days, hours, minutes, and seconds and display it that way. Let me show you what I'm talking about. I'm going to create another measure. And so all this measure does, it takes that measure and then it breaks everything down to days, hours, and minutes. Okay, so we'll get that created. And then I'll add it to my table and you can see days, minutes, hours, seconds. And what the request was, hey, I want to sort this and get it to sort properly. So 120 should be at the bottom and the smallest number of seconds should be at the top. So they basically want the sort of this value to be based on that value. Can't do that with measures. I can do that with columns. Month is the classic one. So I can have the month name and say, base the month name sort off the month number. But how do you do that for a measure? This is where the dynamic format string comes in and helps solve that problem. And so what you would do is, let's just copy this measure right here. Okay, I'm gonna copy this measure, new measure, and I'm gonna paste it in and I'm gonna call it DFS, dynamic format string. So duration in seconds, dynamic format string, the exact same measure that gives us the seconds, okay? And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to the format and I'm gonna switch this to dynamic. This is a preview feature. You'll need to go into the options and then click on preview features and it's still in preview. Where is it? Dynamic format strings. Go ahead and turn it on. It may require a reboot of the desktop. And so once you do that, let's hop over to this page. So you see how the sort is. So I'm gonna go to my new measure. I made the format dynamic and then I'm gonna click this drop down, choose format, and I'm gonna change the format string similar to this measure right here. So we don't need a measure name. So I'm gonna pop that in there and you can see, I'm saying, okay, here's the seconds. It's the selected measure. It's the measure that I have in my visual. And then I start breaking it down into days, hours, minutes, you know, seconds, whatever I want. So we're gonna hit and click check. Right. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that new measure, this one right here, and I'm going to drop it onto the display. And now you'll see how it's broken down. But watch what happens when I do the sort. Look at the numbers, right? It actually corresponds to that particular measure, the measure that's in my grid. So now you can actually see it and it's sorting properly. If I get rid of it, it's still sorting properly. It's a great use case for dynamic format strings. All right, what do you think? Have you ran into this before? Have you solved this a different way? Love to know. Hope this helped someone. You know what to do. If you have questions, comments, post it in the comments below. If you want to learn more about Power BI and DAX, there's probably a video flying above my head. And as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video. Dynamic.